إنه من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له في كتابه العزيز. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإذ قال إبراهيم رب اجعل هذا البلد آمنا واجنبني وبني أن نعبد الأصنام رب إنهن أضللن كثيرا من الناس فمن تبعني فإنه مني ومن عصاني فإنك غفور رحيم. ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون. ربنا إنك تعلم ما نخفي وما نعلن وما يخفى على الله من شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء. الحمد لله الذي وهبني على الكبر إسماعيل وإسحاق إن ربي لسميع الدعاء. رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء. ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the worlds. May His peace, mercy, and blessings be showered on our noble leader Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions, and those who follow his path till the end of time. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for counting us amongst those who will witness these beautiful days of the Hijjah, the peak of which we are experiencing today, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, celebrating and rejoicing in a way that conforms with the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our strivings in the last 10 days. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us witness more of this kind of days on earth. And for our brothers and sisters who are there in a special place doing an important pillar of Islam, Hajj, we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from them hajjan mabruran wa sa'yan mashkuran wa tijaratan lan tabura. It's an opportunity for us, as we have been listening to from our various preachers and imam, that is a period that connects us with our forefather Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, a man chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as his beloved. لقوله سبحانه وتعالى واتخذ الله إبراهيم خليلا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Ibrahim his bosom friend. How beautiful! What level of attainment can a man achieve that can be comparable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that you are my beloved friend? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his mercy and blessings upon him, upon his household, and those who follow the right path among his progeny. An important aspect of his life, which I like to draw my attention and your attention to as believers, is the fact that Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam set the pace. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was making a covenant with him, a promise to him, he said, Qala, inni ja'iluka lin-nasi imama. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I am going to make you the leader of mankind. The leader of mankind. And look at the wisdom. Qala, wa min dhurriyyati. Subhanallah. This is a prophet of Allah, a messenger of Allah, a creator of Allah that is very special. He wasn't selfish. He remembered what means to be yeti. And that is the main focus of my talk, my khutbah. That somebody is so selfless, somebody is not selfish, somebody thinks beyond his nose, somebody thinks beyond his generation. And for those of us who are familiar with Arabic, he could have said, "Wa min abinai," and from amongst my children. "Aw wa min a'ilati," from amongst my family. "Aw usrati," my extended family. No, he said, "Wa min zurriyati." Zurriya means progeny. All the people that will come through your genealogy till the end of time. This can only come from a selfless creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After all, he suffered alone. After all, he sacrificed alone. After all, he went through what he went through alone. So he could have claimed it. But he was very mindful of his progeny. My question is, are we that bothered about what becomes of our progeny? As Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was. If you look at the word Zubriya and do the word search in Al-Quran Al-Kareem, is more often associated with Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam than any other creator, than any other prophet in Al-Quran Al-Kareem, because he was that focused. So, we won't be surprised that from his time up to the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, majority of the prophets that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised were from his genealogy. They can trace their genealogy to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa sallam, the father of this, the father of this, and the father of this. If you read the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then you will start. Ibn Abdul Wahab, Ibn Abdul Muttalib, Abdul Muttalib, then he carried on, carried on, carried on until it reached Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And if there was anybody the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was fond of, it was Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. To the extent that on one occasion Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him a beautiful boy overnight. And he was so pleased to announce to his congregation that Allah has given me a healthy baby boy and has named him after my forefather Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. When the ayah was revealed, لِقَوْلِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. That in Allah, verily Allah and his malaika, his angels, they shower benediction on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All you who believe shower salutation upon him. And the companions came to him. Kayfa nusalli alayka ya Rasulallah. Oh messenger of Allah, how do we shower benediction upon you? How do we pray for you? And he says, "Qulu Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa sallim." Say, "The peace and blessings of Allah be on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." And, you know, they will ask more. Any other way? Then he gave them what we call today Salatul Ibrahimiyya. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim. Till the end. Meaning that today the most popular salat ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Salatul Ibrahimiyya. For us to do, meaning that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is drawing from his experience, drawing from the blessings Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showered on this noble servant of his, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim. As you bless or shower your benediction on Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, ala Ibrahim, and he said, also, till the end of that salah. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very fond of him. To the extent that our pillar of Islam, our Islam is not complete until we do Hajj, as long as we satisfy the conditions. Whoever meets the conditions for Hajj and refuses to do Hajj, his Islam is what? With a question mark. And for you to do Hajj, you are doing what? You are retracing the step of, or the footstep of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Majority of the acts you do, we are doing it. And why are we doing it? We are doing it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to protect his legacy. We are doing it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِقَوْلِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لَقَدْ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ رَسُولَهُ رُؤْيَا بِالْحَقِّ فَتَدْخُلُونَ الْمَسْجِدَ الْحَرَامَ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ آمِنِينَ مُحَلِّقِينَ رُؤُوسَكُمْ وَمُقَصِّرِينَ لَا تَخَافُونَ فَعَلِمَ مَا لَمْ تَعْلَمُوا فَجَعَلَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ دُونِ ذَلِكَ فَتْحًا قَرِيبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled the dream of his apostle Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by making him enter Mecca to do tawaf, to do sa'y, to do hajj. And the final hajj that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did was an object of history. Hatta yawm al-qiyamah. Why is that? Because he gave a khutbah that was unparalleled. A khutbah that connects you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on a continuous basis. A khutbah that connects you, that regulates the relationship between yourself as different clans, tribes, nations, etc., colors, so that it unifies you in the single brotherhood, lillahi of Allah, for Allah's sake. He gave a khutbah that would encourage us to be just and to be fair to all, regardless of how different they may be. And on that note, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, yes, it's the time. Let's draw two lines under this. And he revealed that historical verse. لِقَوْلِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى أَلْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمْ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, today, on this day, أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ, I have perfected for you your religion. Meaning that nothing is remained to be added, it is perfect. Nothing should be deducted because Allah has perfected it. What come to alaykum ni'mati, my blessings have been completed upon you. Wa raditu lakum al-Islam deena, and I am pleased for Islam as your deen, your way of life. Historians had it that when the companions and the Prophet Islam had these verses, they started to shed tears. And they asked one of them, why are you crying? He said, the implication of this verse is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is departing. The implication of this verse is that Islam has reached its zenith. That's the peak of it. Akmaltu lakum dinakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has perfected it. All through the following the footsteps of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa sallam. As I mentioned earlier, he is a man of many parts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made him, he says, وَلَقَدْ اسْتَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him and he raised him in rank. In this world and in the hereafter, he will be among the Salihin, among the righteous ones. So he has so many parts. But to summarize, the personality is a man of Iman. He was a man of Iman, and that's reflected in everything he did. He was selfless, he was ready to sacrifice and pay the supreme price for his Iman. He was ready to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fisarrahi wa dhurra. In the period of adversity and ease, he was prepared. He was ready to part with anything. The most precious was that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the first child when he was of age. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fulfill the dream. part with him. He was ready to resettle his family far away. The word in there is Izarahim. On the valley, or within the valley, there is Izarahim, devoid of any vegetation, devoid of any green, devoid of any plant. It was barren. A barren part of the world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him. He was prepared to be thrown into fire, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rescued him. But one thing which I want to emphasize today is the concept of zuriyati, my progeny. My progeny. He never allowed what people did to him to distract him. He never allowed the challenges he faced in having or raising the children to distract him. He was focused not just on himself, he focused on his iman in preparation to generations yet unborn. So, we quoted the first one. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inni ja'iluka lin-nas imaman, what did he say? Qala wa min dhurriyyati. Oh Allah, don't make it just me. Make that promise, let it flow within my progeny, within those who will come after me from my, amongst my offspring. That's what, when he was making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanallah, very beautiful dua. He says, Oh Allah, رَبَّنَا بَعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. Subhan Allah, beautiful. He says, Oh Allah, those dua are very many. Check Surah Al-Baqarah from around verse 120 upward. You will see the dua of Ibrahim. But the one we want to use here is, Oh Allah, raise from amongst them. What? Rasulan, a messenger that will be rehearsing to them your signs, your ayat. When you alimu humu li kitaba wal hikmah, and you will be able to teach them of what? Of the scripture and of wisdom. When you zakihim, and you will be able to purify them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kuz min amwalihim, min amwalihim, sadaqah. What follows? Allah says, take from them zakah, so that will do what? It will purify them, to purify them. So, the manifestation of that dua was the raising of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulan minhum min al-ummiyin, from amongst the unlettered people. Allah raised a prophet, he himself unlettered. The ability of reading and writing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala withheld it from him. Yet he was the most brilliant. Yet it was an ukuruka fala tansa. It will be rehearsed unto you and you will not forget. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered the dua in how many generations after Ibrahim? Many generations in the personality of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then, when he was making this dua, the one we read earlier. Subhanallah, this is a formula for every parent. This is a formula for any discerning mind that loves the ummah. You know when he started, he says, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَذَا الْبَلَدَ آمِنًا. That's the opening. The environment in which you raise your children is very important. And security is very important. The first thing he prayed for here is, Oh Allah, ij'al hadha al-balada amina. Oh Allah, make this city a city of security, a secure city. In every sense of the word security, let peace reign. Because you can only thrive in an atmosphere of peace and security. If you are in doubt, you hear, you wake up in the morning, have your tea, and you have your pizza, and have this, you don't know what is happening. Ask our colleagues that have traveled over here for asylum, from the Middle East, from Africa, from Asia. Let them narrate their stories for you. And you know what it means to have peace and security. So the opening is, before he did anything, he says, "Oh Allah, ijala hadha al-balada aminan." Then followed by what? Wajnubini wa baniya anna abuda al-aslam. "Oh Allah, ward me off and my children, my progeny, from what? From worshipping idols." Because they have misled a host number of people. They have led them astray. Then look at the second one. It says, "Rabbana, inni askantu min dhurriyyati biwadin ghayri dhi zar'in inda baytika al-muharram." He says, "Oh Allah," that was when he took Ismail and Hajar to Mecca, "a valley devoid of any vegetation, a barren valley, so to say." And he says, "I have," look at that, look at the wisdom. He didn't say my wife and my child or my immediate family. He says, "Min zurriyyati," a portion of my progeny. "I've settled them here. There is the Zarahin in the Bayt al-Muharram, by your sacred house. Rabbana liyuqimu as-salah," oh my Lord, "so that they can establish salah." He didn't say liadai salah, so that they can pray salah. No, so that they can establish salah. There is a difference between the two. And he said, "Yes, that's the purpose, so that they can serve you devotedly." And he says, "Faj'al afwidatan min an-nas tahwi ilayk." "Oh Allah, turn the heart of some amongst mankind to love them and drift towards them." Subhanallah. "Wanzukuhum min al-thamarat," and although it's a barren land, it's a valley, it's a desert, "Wanzukuhum min al-thamarat," and sustain them from fruits and vegetation. "La'allahum yashkurun," so that they can be grateful to you. Subhanallah. And because of time, I move quickly to the last part. It says, "Rabbi ja'alni muqim as-salah." Oh Allah, he was already praying, but he says, "Oh Allah, make me among those who pray." Then he says what? "Wa min dhurriyyati," again, "and among my progeny, make them those who pray, those who observe salah." "Rabbana wa taqabbal du'a." Oh Allah, because you accept dua. So my question to you is, how many times have you prayed in this way? "Oh Allah, create an enabling environment for my family and my progeny to thrive. Oh Allah, make their heart turn towards you. Oh Allah, shower them with love. Oh Allah, put their love in the heart of mankind." You know the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Allah is pleased with somebody, and he will call Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, and he will say, "So-and-so, the son of so-and-so, I love him." Jibreel, love him. And Jibreel will announce to the Malaika al-A'la, the Malaika in heaven, "The son of so-and-so, the son of so-and-so, Allah loves him," and they will all love him. And when they love him, everybody on earth will love him. Subhanallah. Have you prayed like that in your progeny? Or do you just pray to Abdullah and Abdul Rahman and Abdul Rahim? Alhamdulillah, I have just three. He never did that. "Wa min zubriyati." This is very, very important. "And my progeny, till eternity." And then he finally said, "Rabbana ghafirli," oh Allah, forgive me. "Wa liwalidayya," and my parents. "Wa lil mu'minin," and the believers in general. "Yawma yakumu al-hisab," on that very day when you will establish accountability, when you are going to establish justice, when people will account for their deeds. So he connects it to the akhirah, and he knows that we are not ma'zum. "Kullu bani adam khata," we Jesus, Rabbi Gefirini, oh Allah, forgive me. Forgive my parents and forgive the believers. This is how Ummah is important to him. And Allah describes him to say, Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanitan lillah. He was, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, was a nation in his, on his own. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through him, Yaqub, Isahad, all of them came until the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. As parents, as growing youth, this is an example, a very shining and instructive one in the life of our father. And ulama, they said, when you hear the word abikum, abikum, they are only used to refer to two people, two prophets in the Quran. The first one is our biological father, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. So you say abikum Adam. And the other one is abikum Ibrahim. Millata abikum Ibrahim. Huwa sammakum al-muslimina min qabli wa fi hadha. He says, is the way, the religion, the path of your father Ibrahim. Meaning that Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is our spiritual father. We are all connected to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam on a daily basis. Because you read Salatu Ibrahim, don't you? You perform Hajj, don't you? You do all this, they are connected through the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And a very important aspect of his life is the power of dua. And it's a sign of iman. When you make dua, what it means is you have placed yourself where you belong and you have placed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala where he belongs. And you are saying, Anta ghaniyyu ya Rabb wa ana faqir ilayka. I am a poor person. I have no power, no might, no wisdom except you. Give me this. And when you are praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pray with sincerity. Pray by fulfilling the obligations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. Pray according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And finally, don't pray for yourself alone. Extend it to who? Wa min zurriyati. And the generations that will come through you in later years. Wa lil mu'minin. Pray for the ummah. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنا اقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه انه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاه وتسليما على رسوله الذي اصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه العزيز اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين وانصر عبادك المؤمنين. اللهم انصرنا وانصر إخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم ربنا آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم يا سامع الصوت ويا سابق الفوت ويا كاسع العظام لحم بعد الموت لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما الا فرجته ولا كربا الا نفسته ولا دينا الا قضيته ولا مريضا الا شفيته ولا حاجه من هوائج الدنيا وفي الاخره هي لك رضا ولنا فيها صلاه الا انت على قضائها ويسرتها برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. قوموا الى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.